Dear students, in this session, I am going to discuss about an one-dimensional problem in FEM. It describes about the application of Gauss elimination techniques. So analyze the given structure, which is circular in area of cross section using FEM, by discretizing it into four elements. So the figure is given. So this is the structure. And it is subjected to an axial load 5 kN. The length of the structure is 1200 mm, and the diameter is given 100 mm, and Young's modulus 2 × 10⁵ N/mm². And the second step is we have to discretize the structure into nodes and elements. In the problem it is given that we have to discretize the structure into 4 elements. Therefore we are having 5 nodes are there. If the nodes are numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and elements are numbered as in circled form, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. And U1, U2, U3, U4, U5 are the displacement at each node. F1, F2, F3, F4 and F5 are the forces corresponding to each node. And each element is having the length is equal to 300 mm. As already said, here the structure is to be discretized into 4 elements. Hence the structure will have 5 nodes. As the structure is approximated by one-dimensional elements, each node will have single degree of freedom. As the finite element model is having 5 nodes and each node is having single degree of freedom, global stiffness matrix will be having the size 5/5. So the next step is we have to formulate the element stiffness matrices. As we know that the element stiffness matrix for each element will be AE/L × 1 − 1 − 1 × U1 U2 = F1 F2. This is for the first element. Likewise, we have to continue this one. So already we studied those things in the previous videos. That is why I am skipping that step and straight away going to formulate the global stiffness matrix. Hence we can formulate the global stiffness matrix with the 5 rows and 5 columns. Why it is 5 rows and 5 columns? Because we are having 5 nodes. Each node is having single degree of freedom. Therefore the element stiffness matrix will be having the size 5/5. So we are having the 5 rows. This is R1, R2, R3, R4 and R5. This is column matrix. C1, C2, C3, C4 and C5. So 5/5. And after assembling the element stiffness matrix of the first element, we are having 1 − 1 − 1 × 2. Actually here we are having U1, U2 which is equal to F1, F2. But for the assembly, so all the displacement are shown here. Okay, this shows after assembling the element stiffness matrix of first and second element. So this is for the first element, 1 − 1 − 1, and this is for the second element. Since the second node is common to first element and second element, this will be 1 + 1. Okay, so 1 − 1 − 1, and this matrix is showing the assembled global stiffness matrix after the first, second and third elements. And this is the global stiffness matrix that obtained after assembling element stiffness matrices of all the elements. We are having 4 elements here. That is why the stiffness matrix, the global stiffness matrix will be AE/L × because AE/L is common to all. That is why AE/L × 1 − 1 − 1, 1. Then you see this diagonal in all the nodes, that is intermediate nodes, it will be added 1 + 1, here also 1 + 1 and here also 1 + 1. Likewise it is added ongoing in the subsequent nodes. You can see that these cells are vacant, so the remaining cells will be filled with zeros to obtain in the actual global stiffness matrix. So next step is to apply boundary conditions. So two types of boundary conditions already we studied: displacement boundary condition and force boundary condition. And in the structure, the first node is fixed, therefore u1 is equal to 0. And also in the structure, in the last node, that is at the end, it is subjected to an axial load of 5 kN. Therefore, that is Fi is equal to 5000 N. Okay, so next step is the solution. So we have already applied the boundary conditions. Therefore, u1 is equal to 0. Since u1 is equal to 0, first row and first column can be cancelled. Therefore, this first row and first column has been cancelled here. So after cancelling the first row and first column, the remaining matrix is as follows. So you can see this is 1 plus 1, minus 1, 0, 0. And you can see that now itself it is a 4 by 4 matrix. Therefore, we cannot find out the solutions, that is the displacement, using the conventional techniques. Therefore, we have to make use of advanced matrix manipulation techniques. So, to solve this 4 by 4 matrix, we need to consider Gaussian elimination technique. Okay. So, AE by L into the remaining matrix after cutting the first row and first column, that into U2, U3, U4, U5, which is equal to F2, F3, F4 and F5. Okay, according to the Gaussian elimination techniques, what we have to do is that the matrix should be initially set as, so you have to write this matrix initially, and after that you draw a line, dotted line. Then after that we have to write the parameters in the right hand side as a separate column. So in this way you have to arrange this matrix for finding out the solution. Okay, so the same stiffness matrix here, and after that one line, and after that as a separate column you have to write the parameters in the right hand side. Okay, so now all are in a single matrix.